Hello and welcome to Concepts in Epidemiology, Descriptive Study Designs. The learning outcomes of this presentation are to 1. Understand the characteristics of major descriptive study designs. 2. Describe the advantages and disadvantages of descriptive research. And 3. Identify the main characteristics of the following subtypes of descriptive research design, including case reports, case series, cross-sectional, and ecological studies. Descriptive research designs are conducted to attempt to describe the distribution of specific observational and experimental variables, such as patterns of disease distribution, behaviors and disease risk, and socioeconomic factors as moderators to health and disease. It is important to note that descriptive research does not seek to establish causal relationships. The specific types of research in this presentation are the following case reports: case series, cross-sectional studies, and ecological studies. A case report refers to the description of a single patient with an unusual disease or with simultaneous occurrence of more than one type of disease. This type of research seeks to establish or estimate trends in the development of a disease, but falls short of establishing causation to the specific development or cause of a disease. This slide contains an example of a case study which features one person, which inherently makes it a case report. A case series is different from a case report in that it involves observations conducted on more than one person versus one person in a case report. Case series studies are aggregations, combinations, of multiple or similar cases sharing common connections to the development and expression of disease. Further, case series studies are largely anecdotal in nature and have limited to no experimental generalizability. This slide contains an example of a case series involving more than one study participant, men. Cross-sectional research study designs involve the collection of information on the presence or level of one or more variables of interest, like behaviors, diseased conditions, and levels of exposure. Cross-sectional research looks across various ages, disease risk factors, socioeconomic factors, or disease characteristics for commonalities across a specific period of time, such as a year, or month, or day. This slide illustrates the basic structure of a cross-sectional study design. Controls and cases are each randomly taken from a study population and then examined or observed from exposure to a specific disease risk factor. The study population is selected based on heterogeneity of individuals, which vary in age, ethnic, and other demographic characteristics. This slide gives another example of cross-sectional research. In this design, the various classes, or grades, serve as the various sections across which variables are explored. Ecological Research Study, ESD, designs involve looking for associations between an exposure, like secondhand smoke, and an outcome, like lung disease. ESDs are particularly useful when the difference in exposure between individuals within a group are much smaller than the differences in exposure between groups, differences between 20-year-olds versus differences between 20, 30, and 40-year-olds. See an example of an ESD involving death rates and firearm ownership on this slide. This slide discusses the main advantages and disadvantages of descriptive research designs. Most advantages center around ease of execution and pragmatic speed and simplicity. The disadvantages involve around non-generalizability and lack of experimental rigor. Descriptive research study designs are those that seek to describe the distribution of specific experimental or observational variables within, and sometimes across, time and context. Case reports, case series, and cross-sectional studies involve investigations of people, usually individual people, while ecological studies look at groups of people. Descriptive research study designs have many advantages and a few disadvantages, highlighted in slides above, but are generally useful for both planning purposes and explorations for future research. Thank you for watching, and have a great day.